Hello, everybody. I'm Cédric Bélanger from Marketing Communication Department. Today, I'm very pleased to co-present with Ludovic Manier, HUD Functional Innovation Expert, our solutions to support the development of the HUD in automotive. First, a few words about Optis. Optis is a world-leading company providing physics-based software for simulating the performances of light, simulating the human vision, and finally experiencing your product in its final context. So thanks to Optis, you virtually see what you will get. Automotive is a passion for Optis for more than 25 years, 28 years exactly. The subject is even more interesting that it is today at the forefront of technology and style, an area in constant and fast mutation where the stakes are important. First, I will start with the trends and challenges. Our solution will be developed by Ludovic Manier. I will finish with our vision about virtual prototyping and the customer testimonials. When the cluster and an infotainment console requires a driver to take his eyes away from the road for a few seconds, instantly the HUD connects the driver with the information that is needed now. HUD supplement the exterior view of the traffic conditions, allowing the drivers to register faster the driving situation they are in. HUD is a very promising driver assistance that will help to make driving even more comfortable and safe, but the usage are still to be defined in order to better guide, alert, warn the drivers without disturbing them. Some figures regarding the market trend. The volume of both windscreen and combiner will increase. While windscreen HUD represent 80% today, check the blue line, they will not replace the combiner models, and the combiners, check the gray line, will even increase their market share in the coming years to almost 30%. For TechNavio, HUD market in the transportation sector will have a constant annual growth of 28% till 2021. That means doubled every 3 years. They foresee an increasing demand of AR HUD like IHS, with around 2020 an explosion of AR HUDs that will launch the function into most major luxury brands. As augmented reality will have to be in the vehicle within 2-3 years, R&D needs to be started now. The technological competition has already started, and today all the premium car makers are basing their communication on augmented reality head-up displays. BMW, the next 100 concept, Toyota Concept i, Volkswagen Concept ID. Cross, even the suppliers are communicating on AR as Continental, Visteon, and Harman. I will let Ludovic Manier explain how Optis dedicated solution support these challenges in HUD development.
Thank you, Cédric. Before to introduce the Optis solution, I'd like to start by a review of the typical head-up display development process with the chain of design steps and the car maker and suppliers interaction. At the really beginning, it starts with a human factor or HMI department, which define the characteristic of the head-up display image and also the content of the image to display. Then, because the windshield act an optical component of the head-up display, the glazing department is involved. This require iteration between OEM style departments and glazing department, and also the windshield supplier. It continues then with the packaging department that have to keep enough space behind the instrument panel for the head-up display projector. This time, it's mainly iteration between the OEM and the projector supplier, which are required. Then the projector supplier design the illumination system for the PGU, for the picture generation unit, and then from the optical system definition, pre-distortion of the image, the warping is implemented. One time more, collaboration between optics team and electronic is necessary because the input of the processing come from the optical analysis. Finally, the full optical system, that is to say the windshield, the mirrors, the PGU and even the warping, is validated in terms of image quality. Consequences of the tolerance on manufacturing variation could be also analyzed here. I'd like to continue with an analogy between head-up display and exterior lighting development process. Here, it's a lamp development process that have been introduced by Volkswagen some years ago at the ISAL conference. What is interesting to notice here is the fact that the OEM is involved in the design of optical components at the early stage of the design, before the supply or is involved. It means that they have the team and the tools to initiate the conceptual design and also the technical feasibility. This enables very quick iteration loop between OEM departments such as the styling, the optics, the packaging, much earlier than the moment when the supplier is nominated. Then the concept or the pre-development better prepare is transferred for the engineering to the tier one, saving multiple iteration. Having the same tool on both the OEM and the supplier side can significantly improve the communication, and even more if it's integrated in the same CAD platform, CATIA V5 or NX. After the engineering, the car maker proceed to the test and the validation up to the tool go. We can see now how all the brands of the group have a very strong lighting signature, since similar process have been implemented by duplicated by other OEM. At Optis, we believe that such process is going to be implemented also for head-up display, and it's the objective of the head-up display solution here is effectively to provide tools to support the implementation of such process. Let me now introduce an overview of the head-up display solution. Basically, it relies on two fundamentals. The first one is a virtual reality environment because it places the user, the driver, at the heart of the head-up display experience. Based on our VR platform, it displays in real time the head-up display image in immersive environment with stereo display and tracking system. And these both at the early stage of the process to specify the ideal HUD virtual image characteristic and also image content, and then at the final stage to assess intuitively and interactively the perceived quality of the actual HUD virtual image as seen by the driver. In parallel to the VR environment, we offer a CAD integrated set of tools. Because the CAD PLM is really the key platform for all the engineering tasks and the collaboration between all OEMs departments and suppliers. We find here features to design and analyze the lighting performances of the PGU, such as luminance, uniformity and colors, and also features to design the imaging optical system, the mirrors, and also to validate it against the acceptance criteria. So following now the design process stages, I'm going to introduce several use cases with both the challenges of the industry and the solution we can provide. So for the very early stage of the process, we are now enhancing our driving simulator with dedicated head-up display feature. Today, it is used to specify or define the intelligent lighting strategy, and later in the process to assess headlights design in order to avoid costly physical prototype. Especially in the context of augmented reality, the vision parameters such as the image distance, the look down angle, the horizontal and vertical field of view becomes a real challenge because of the complexity of the driving scenario with the traffic, multiple lanes, vulnerable road user, turn, intersection, and so on. And also the multiplicity of the targeted ADAS features, the navigation, the adaptive cruise control, the lane departure warning, and so on. Naturally, the image distance play a key role to reduce the visual depth difference between real object and virtual information. Active cruise control is probably the more demanding features regarding the vertical field of view, as only the overlap between the image seen by both the short and the tall driver can be used to guarantee the same level of functionality, whatever the driver size. Augmented reality head-up display is going to play an important role to facilitate the adoption of autonomous driving. It will help to build confidence of the drivers in the vehicle detection system by intuitively highlighting the key elements of the driving scene. Further than the image specification, that's also all the embedded software from the sensor signal processing up to the HUD image generation that can be developed and evaluated on the simulation platform. VR capability helps to select the best visualization strategy by providing lifelike experience to test how the industry expert or even the consumer appraise different display options. The solution we propose here is the ability to connect real-time realistic visualization and embedded software in a co-simulation. The diagram here describes the architecture we are building, with at the center the Optis driving simulator, with a physical lighting simulation in the background to create an accurate and reliable visualization, which is connected to the head-up display module managing the display of the image. In parallel, we find the embedded software component managing sensor fusions, which is fed by the simulator. Then, head-up display image generator, creating the virtual image sent back to the visualization, to the head-up display visualization on the top of the scene. The architecture can even be extended to integrate the car head-up display HMI for the driver to adjust, for example, the brightness, the height, or the rotation of the image in order to provide a holistic lifelike experience. So here it's a video of proof of concept of this solution. As you can see here, we have a co-simulation between the driving simulation, the lighting simulation, and the display of the virtual head-up display image. The head-up display image is calculated here in real time from information coming from the simulator, such as the speed and additional ADAS information, for instance, the forward collision warning and the lane departure warning, as you can see now. So the AR HUD is going to bring a new paradigm for the communication between the vehicle and the driver. That is very important to investigate from the safety standpoint. Here again, the driving experience with simulator bring many benefit to investigate how the drivers would react in some critical driving simulation. Some human factor studies highlight some risk for the safety. For example, the traffic psychology and behavior stated that in all AR condition, the ability to extract information is less efficient. On the left image, the driver will detect, we will see the green navigation instruction to turn on the right. But be focused on it, we'll see the red light on the top right, which should make a stop. Another study from the Comiglid division of visual attention conclude that digital messages on vehicle windscreen made driving less safe. Such a study show the necessity to conduct human factor studies to evaluate the best option to communicate information to the driver without disturbing his or her attention from the driving tasks. Then, from the head-up display virtual image characteristics obtained from at the specification stage, the pre-development of the optical system itself, or the concept, can start. In order to find compromise between optical performances and volume constraint, we propose here dedicated features integrated in the CAD. So embedding also the optical neuro in order to be usable by casual CAD engineer. Moreover, it is available at in the as it is available in the CAD platform, it drastically facilitates the collaboration between multiple teams. So let's now view a recording of the design of an AR HUD with dual images. It was designed with Speos head-up display optical design feature integrated in CATIA V5. So you can note that the panel have the same look and feel than any CATIA V5 features, so it accelerates the learning curve. The user starts by defining the target image. I go back a little bit. Of the near layer, so it's a 2.2 for the virtual image distance and 4.2 for the field of view. And then the tool optimize the shape to get the best performances. Then the operation, the same operation are done for the far layer. This time it's 10 meters for the virtual image distance and 8x5 for the vertical field of view. The optical layout now includes two freeform mirrors to reduce the size of the packaging. And you can see in red the optical axis preview updated in real time. The tool also creates the optical volume to check potential interference with mechanical parts, and just by editing the layout parameters, several alternative concepts can be created to find the best solution with regards of the volume constraints. With the upcoming release in December this year, we will introduce an interactive layout functionality. It is introduced here for the very first time today. It will provide 3D interactive preview of inputs, that is to say the target image, the eyebox, and the optical axis, which are updated in real time during the edition of any input parameters, such as the distance, the look of handle, and the field of view. But above all, a preview of the mirror's geometry is updated in real time, drastically facilitating the layout according to mechanical constraint, the user having an immediate feedback of the consequence of any parameter change. So now, once the optical design is created, the optical performance have to be evaluated and compared with the specification or between several design options or technical proposal in order to identify the best one. Here again, we propose a dedicated feature available within the CAD platform to facilitate the usage by non-experts. It generates a report with customizable optical metrics such as dynamic distortion, ghosting, image sharpness, or visual disparity. On the right, a radar plot summarizes the optical quality, each radial axis being associated to an optical defect. The smaller the shape is, the best the design is. The red, green, and blue curves reflect the performance of several design proposals. The black curve depicts the OEM acceptance criteria. So very quickly and intuitively, we can find out what the red proposal is the best, and that the green and the blue one don't achieve the requirements. Let's now view a recording of an analysis of a windshield-based LED display. This time, the CAD platform is NX. The user starts by defining the eye boxes with the short, the medium, and the tall driver. Then it defines the target image with here it's a 2.4 for the virtual image distance and 7x3 for the field of view. Then it selects the inner face and the outer face. Then the mirrors, the geometry, and define the rotation angles associated for each driver size. Then the PGU positioning is defined thanks to an axis system and the size defined in a predefined list. The virtual image is corresponding to each driver size are calculated and visualized in the 3D view, as well as the typical optical metrics such as the field curvature, the spot size, the astigmatism, the ghosting, and the dynamic distortion. The optical volume can be visualized to check interference between the mechanical part. And finally, the warping of the PGU is created to feed the pre-distortion algorithm for the embedded software. Today, car makers have their own definition for the optical metrics and acceptance criteria. This creates the need to generate different types of reports according to the vehicle program. In another hand, the definition of the optical metrics and the acceptance criteria contains intellectual properties to protect. That's why we have created a dedicated software architecture for that. With a product available as a component of the on the shelf, calculated, I would say, the low-level optical calculation. This part is integrated in the CAD platform and call at the end the analysis. At the end of the analysis, a software component, a DLL, which implement individually the OEM specific requirement. The car maker having the ownership, the IP is protected, and the OEM can share it with his own ecosystem to receive report perfectly matching its expectation. This component can potentially be plugged on a measurement device to facilitate the comparison between report coming from the simulation during the development phase and report from the metrology department at the beginning of the production. Of course, reports can be stored in the PDM system to capitalize the know from project to project. The tools calculating both the primary image reflected on the inner face of the windshield and the secondary image created by a reflection on the outer face of the windshield. The ghosting can be calculated for all combination between the eye box and the virtual image. The optimal wedge minimizing the cost can be determined to obtain the best perceived quality with regards of the costing. By modeling in detail the PGU with LED, reflective or refractive parts, films and LCD, Speos can perform luminance simulation of the full system for the entire eye box, this in order to evaluate the uniformity and the brightness of the virtual image. The stray light, a light coming from the sun, creating hotspots in the field of view of the driver after unexpected reflection in the projector, can also be anticipated. Critical sun direction and light path can be identified and fixed in order to avoid very costly re-engineering after production is started. Finally, adding the design of the other parts, such as the dashboard, the pillars, the instrument panel, a complete lifelike visual experience can be performed. We can already propose a pre-computed simulation from the CAD environment, but from the end of this year, we will propose a real-time VR solution for this. Here is a preview of the upcoming product, HUD Visual Experience. It will provide a stereoscopic display of the virtual image calculated thanks to with real-time ray tracing. It relies on optical simulation using the driver eyes position provided by a tracking system. The virtual image is added on the top of the scene, which include both the interior and the exterior vehicle, the behavior of the optical system for different look down angle, virtual image distance or field of view can be tested. VR can even provide experiences which are not possible in the real world with physical prototype. For example, here, the perception of the virtual image by a driver who do not have the size of the current user. The tools can be used to compare different image contents proposal for ADAS use cases and test the correct overlapping between the head-up display image and the object from the exterior environment to highlight. So for different use cases. The typical head-up display image defect can be reproduced to validate the general perceived quality. It's illustrated here with static distortion coming from the warping, the dynamic distortion, the ghosting. Both the primary and secondary image are calculated in real time. Also, the veiling glare, the reflection of the sun on the dashboard, then on the windshield up to the driver eyes, and even the unexpected light paths are managed, as you can see currently, with multiple reflection. And finally, the vignetting of the image because of two small mirrors. And finally, the visual disparity as both eyes do not perceive the image at the same location. So several VR installations are possible based either on a desktop, head-mounted devices, or a power wall. So, Cédric, as a conclusion, the OPTIS head-up display solution can address several use cases all along the design process to specify the head-up display vision parameters and also image content, especially for augmented reality, to design the lighting and the the optical system for from the CAD platform to facilitate the collaboration between teams, and finally to assess the driver perception in a lifelike experience.
Thank you, Ludo. For head-up displays is a sterling feature, and the tools you are developing to design it are impressive. As a synthesis, I want to share the global Optis vision. The goal of Optis is to enable you in delivering innovative design that have been tested and optimized for your final customer. We assist you in many aspects, including safety, ergonomics, and perceived quality. This translates to several topics: color and material choice and uniformity, human-machine interface development, interior lighting, intelligent exterior lighting, and the current hot topics of HUD and globally ADAS and autonomous driving. Basically, Optis enables innovation for you anywhere light, lighting, human vision, and sensor vision are involved. Customer testimonials. We have already many references for several use cases on the head-up display. I just wanted to focus on BMW and Kenneth Veslake feedback. Kenneth is activity is optimization of the customer's visual experience. He is trying to look into the future and guide decisions to ensure customers share driving pleasure. That's the baseline of BMW, the customer promise of BMW. The benefits using our tool: eliminate costly physical models, quickly simulate many what-if scenario and compare concepts, make critical decisions based on physically correct, realistic results, and the more important, improve drastically the experience of BMW customers. We have a global worldwide presence for local understanding. So I hope that we have convinced you, we are the best partner to help you design your head-up system. So I invite you to contact your local dealer and ask for an evaluation. Thank you very much. I wish you a brilliant day. Bye-bye.